Today we are going to discuss macrolide, lincosamide, glycopeptide and other antibacterial antibiotics. So macrolide antibiotic, why we call them macrolide? Because chemical structure of macrolide is a macrocyclic or multi-membered lactone ring. Lactone ring is a multi-membered lactone ring or macrocyclic lactone ring to which deoxy sugars are attached. Deoxy sugars are attached to the multi-membered lactone ring, that's why the name is macrolides. Erythromycin was the first member discovered in 1950s. Erythromycin was the first member. There are only four macrolides: erythromycin, roxithromycin, clarithromycin and azithromycin. So these are the newer macrolide. Erythromycin is the prototype drug of macrolide. Means, what is mean by prototype drug? It represents the whole class of the drugs, erythromycin. Now erythromycin is obtained from Streptomyces erythrus in 1952. Erythromycin, it is obtained from Streptomyces erythrus in 1952. So it's a natural antibiotic because it's obtained from Streptomyces erythrus. It is more effective at alkaline pH. The property of erythromycin is it is more effective at alkaline pH. Erythromycin is a bacteriostatic drug at a low concentration, but it is a bactericidal at a high concentration for certain bacteria only, not for the all. Erythromycin actually, it's a bacteriostatic at low concentration, but bactericidal at high concentration for certain bacteria only. Mechanism of action, it binds with the P site of 50S ribosomal subunit and inhibit the translocation of growing peptide chain from A site to P site. Hence, acceptor site is not available for binding of next amino acid brought by tRNA and hence protein synthesis stops. Now, what is the mechanism of action? This erythromycin binds to the which ribosomal subunit? 50S ribosomal subunit. Which part of 50S ribosomal subunit? P site of 50S ribosomal subunit. Now, for the growth of peptide chain or growing peptide chain needs amino acid. Now there is a A site, there is a P site. A site means acceptor site, P site means peptidyl site. Now this erythromycin binds to the P site of 50S ribosomal subunit. There is a continuous translocation. Translocation means shifting. There is a continuous translocation of amino acid from A site to the P site. There is a continuous shifting of amino acid from A site to the P site. A site will accept, it will transfer to the P site and it will help in the growth of the chain. It will help in the growth of peptide chain. Now from where this A site is getting amino acid? From the tRNA. Amino acid is brought by tRNA to the A site. Now it is shifted to the P site or translocated to the P site and that's how it goes. But when erythromycin binds to the P site of 50S ribosomal subunit, then what will happen? A site is not available for binding of next amino acid brought by tRNA. Why it is not available? Because it has already having amino acid which is not transferred to the P site. Why it is not transferred to the P site? Because erythromycin is binding to the 50S ribosomal subunit on the P site. So it will not going to take any new amino acid which is brought by tRNA, and that's why there is a inhibition of protein synthesis. Antimicrobial spectrum, gram-positive and gram-negative bacteria, gram-positive and few gram-negative. In addition to that, Campylobacter, Legionella, Bramnella, Gardnerella and Mycoplasma, means narrow antimicrobial spectrum. It is effective against gram-positive, few gram-negative and apart from that, Campylobacter, Legionella, Mycoplasma, Gardnerella. Resistance. Why erythromycin is not so much popular? Because there is occurrence of resistance through plasmid, in which there is a involvement of ERM gene. So resistance occurs through the plasmid. Inactivation of drugs by the enzymes like hydrolase. Decrease affinity of ribosome to the macrolides. Decrease influx. Increase efflux by efflux pump mechanism. Why there is a resistance? Resistance occurs through plasmid with the help of ERM gene. There is inactivation of drug by the various enzymes like hydrolase. Decrease affinity of ribosome to the macrolide, means that macrolide will not going to bind that ribosome because there is a decreased affinity. Decrease influx means that bacteria will not enter into the macrolide will not enter into the bacteria because there is a decreased influx because transportation is inhibited. Increase efflux, whatever the drug is accumulating inside the bacteria, it will get expelled by the efflux pump mechanism. Now, pharmacokinetics. This erythromycin is adequately absorbed from upper GI tract after oral administration. It is get adequately absorbed. But what is the problem? It is acid labile. It will destroyed by the gastric juice. It will destroyed by the gastric acid or hydrochloric acid. So it is acid labile. Hence, it is preferred in enteric coated tablet form. Food interferes with the absorption. Do not cross blood-brain barrier, but it crosses placental barrier. What does that mean? Do not cross blood-brain barrier. So it is not effective in meningeal infection. But cross placental barrier, so it's a teratogenic. It achieves effective concentration in prostatic fluid. So we can treat bacterial prostatitis. If it achieves effective concentration in prostatic fluid, so we can treat bacterial prostatitis. It is metabolized in the liver through cytochrome P450. It is metabolized in the liver through cytochrome P450, so there is a chance of drug interaction. It can cause QT prolongation. It's a microsomal enzyme inhibitor, so there is a chance of drug interaction. It will inhibit the metabolism of various drugs like warfarin, theophylline. Plasma T-half is very short, so it is given 4 times in a day or QID. Plasma T-half is very short, so it is given 4 times in a day. Excreted mainly in the feces via bile. So these are the pharmacokinetic properties. Adverse effects, it's a gastrointestinal disturbances like nausea, vomiting, abdominal cramp, diarrhea due to increased peristalsis. Why there is a diarrhea? Because there is an increase in the peristaltic movement because it acts on the motilin receptor. It stimulates the motilin receptors. So there is a diarrhea. Reversible hearing impairment, it's ototoxic, but it's a reversible. Say hypersensitivity reactions like rash, eosinophilia. There is a chance of hepatitis with cholestatic jaundice with acetolate ester preparation. Erythromycin acetolate ester preparation, it may cause hepatitis with cholestatic jaundice, which resemble with the viral hepatitis or extrahepatic biliary obstruction. So it may get wrongly treated. Why it may get wrongly treated? Because this hepatitis and cholestatic jaundice resembles with the viral hepatitis or extrahepatic biliary obstruction. So it may get wrongly treated because it is wrongly diagnosed and it is more common with the acetolate ester preparation. Drug interactions, rise in the plasma level of theophylline, carbamazepine, valproate, ergotamine and warfarin. Why? Because it's a microsomal enzyme inhibitor. So it inhibits the metabolism of theophylline, it inhibits the metabolism of carbamazepine, valproate, ergotamine, warfarin. So there is a chance of drug interaction. It is metabolized by CYP3A4 enzyme or cytochrome P450 enzyme. So there is a chance of QT prolongation. Serious ventricular arrhythmias, death have been reported due to inhibition of CYP3A4. So where we use this erythromycin as an alternative to penicillin. Erythromycin is used as an alternative to penicillin in the infections like streptococcal pharyngitis. Pharyngitis because of streptococci, that is streptococcal pharyngitis, or infections of the tonsils like tonsillitis, mastoiditis, and community acquired respiratory infection. So as an alternative to penicillin, it is also used in diphtheria because it will eliminate the carrier state. It is also used in case of tetanus, syphilis, gonorrhea. Syphilis and gonorrhea are the sexually transmitted diseases in which you can use erythromycin, but as an alternative to penicillin. Leptospirosis, it's a leptospirosis in which you can use erythromycin as an alternative to the penicillin. Now, first choice drug for the atypical pneumonia, where it is used as a first choice drug, in atypical pneumonia caused by mycoplasma pneumoniae, whooping cough, which is caused by Bordetella pertussis, and it's a drug of choice for the treatment and post-exposure prophylaxis. In the chancroid is a sexual transmitted disease caused by Haemophilus ducreyi. So here you can use as erythromycin as a drug of choice. In atypical pneumonia caused by mycoplasma pneumoniae, whooping cough, which is caused by Bordetella pertussis, chancroid, which is caused by Haemophilus ducreyi. But limitations of erythromycin: it is acid labile because it is destroyed by the gastric juice, gastric acid or HCl. Narrow spectrum means it is effective against gram positive, few gram negative. So narrow spectrum. Shorter duration of action because of shorter half-life. So four times in a day, dose is 4 times in a day. So shorter duration of action. Low oral bioavailability, only 30-40% oral bioavailability. So because of all these limitations, patient is showing poor compliance. So these are the limitations or drawbacks of erythromycin, and that's why there is a need of newer macrolides in the form of roxithromycin. Roxithromycin is a semi-synthetic, longer-acting macrolide. It's acid-stable, nothing to do with gastric acidity or gastric juice or HCl. It's acid-stable. It is more potent as compared to the erythromycin, because erythromycin is 500 mg, this is 150 mg, so more potent, better absorb, better tissue penetration, it will get better absorbed, better tissue penetration. It is not a microsomal enzyme inducer or inhibitor, so no drug interaction. It is more effective against Legionella. It is alternative to erythromycin, but it is more expensive. That is the only disadvantage. It is, all the properties are having advantages over erythromycin, but only thing, it is expensive as compared to the erythromycin. Roxithromycin is a semi-synthetic, longer acting drug, acid stable, more potent, better absorbed, better tissue penetration, no drug interactions, more effective against Legionella. Now clarithromycin, 250-500 mg, it is more effective against H. influenzae, H. pylori and Legionella. Clarithromycin, wider spectrum, it is more effective against H. influenzae, Helicobacter pylori and Legionella. It is more effective against Mycobacterium avium complex, that is a MAC infection. It is also effective against Mycobacterium leprae and some anaerobes, but is not effective against Bacteroides fragilis. So clarithromycin is the only macrolide which is effective against Mycobacterium avium complex. It is only macrolide which is effective against Mycobacterium avium complex. It is the only macrolide which is effective against Mycobacterium leprae. The thing you should know, clarithromycin is the only macrolide which is effective against Mycobacterium leprae. That's why we can use in the leprosy. It is also effective in MAC infection. What is MAC infection? Mycobacterium avium complex in the AIDS patient. But it is not effective against Bacteroides fragilis. So we can't use in case of lung abscess, pelvic abscess or abdominal abscess, which is caused by Bacteroides fragilis. It's a component of triple regimen in peptic ulcer. Why it's a component of triple regimen? Because effective against H. pylori. So 80% of the peptic ulcer are because of H. pylori. So it's a component of triple regimen in peptic ulcer. Structurally similar to erythromycin and inhibit the cytochrome P450. If it is structurally similar to erythromycin and inhibit cytochrome P450, means there is a QT prolongation, there is a drug interactions. It is more acid stable, slightly larger tissue distribution, excreted in urine, hence dose reduction is done in renal failure. Now azithromycin is a wonder drug, 500 mg once a day. It's a new azelaide congener of erythromycin. It's a congener of erythromycin, but has an expanded spectrum. These are the advantages. Wider spectrum or expanded spectrum. improved pharmacokinetic properties, better tolerability, means well tolerated drug, and no interaction, no drug interaction at all. So longest half-life, more than 50 hours, and this is the reason this azithromycin is given as a single dose in most of the infection, because the longest half-life, more than 50 hours. This is the reason it is given as a single dose is enough for most of the infection, most of the sexually transmitted infection. No effect on CYP3A4, so no QT prolongation. It's not a microsomal enzyme inhibitor, so no drug interaction, no QT prolongation. It's acid stable. The remarkable pharmacokinetic properties are acid stability, nothing to do with gastric acid, rapid oral absorption from empty stomach. It will get better absorbed on empty stomach, means the azithromycin is given 2 hours before meal and 4 hours after meal, because rapid oral absorption after empty stomach. Larger tissue distribution and intracellular penetration. So it can kill the various intracellular microorganisms because intracellular penetration is excellent. Particularly high concentrations are attained inside macrophages and fibroblast. Volume of distribution is 30 liters per kg. 30 liters per kg. So this azithromycin is given as a first choice drug in the Legionnaire's pneumonia, chlamydial trachomatis. It is also given in the donovanosis, which is a sexually transmitted disease, chancroid, and urethritis. It is also given in urethritis, chancroid, donovanosis, chlamydia trachomatis, Legionnaire's pneumonia as a first choice drug. But why it is called as a respiratory macrolide? Because it is effective against mycoplasma, pneumonia, chlamydia, legionella, moraxella, H. influenza, campylobacter. That's why it is called as a Azithromycin is called as a respiratory macrolide. Whatever the infection of respiratory tract, whether it is upper respiratory tract infection, lower respiratory infection, it is given as a drug of choice. Good activity against MAC, that is Mycobacterium avium complex, and Trypanosomia gonadine. Spiromycin, it resembles erythromycin in spectrum of activity and properties. It limits the risk of transplacental transmission of Toxoplasma gonadine infection. It is mainly used for the toxoplasmosis in AIDS patient and during pregnancy, leading to the recurrent absorption. Spiromycin, it resembles erythromycin in spectrum of activity and properties. The only indication of spiromycin is it limits the risk of transplacental transmission of Toxoplasma gonadine infection. It is mainly used for the toxoplasmosis in AIDS patient and during pregnancy, leading to the recurrent abortion. So this is all about the macrolides.